of the 98th graduating class of Destrehan High School. I am Brianna Anderson, Executive Board President. Please remain standing for the invocation, the Pledge of Allegiance, National Anthem, and the Alma Mater. The invocation will be delivered by Madison Lumar, Senior Class President.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask that you watch over our graduates as we leave tonight and begin a new chapter of our lives. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to be here and celebrate our hard work and dedication. We ask that you bless us with the ability to find our passion and success and make responsible decisions that will benefit our future and the common good. Lord, thank you for guiding us through this four-year journey. We know it wasn't easy, and it is through you that we are able to sit here proudly tonight. Please allow us to always remember the knowledge, skills, experiences, and insights gained through our education at Destrehan High School, even through adverse times. While leaving the people that we've known our whole lives is sad, please let us cherish these moments and always be grateful for our blessings. Be with us this day and forevermore. Amen.
Please remain standing for the pledge, the national anthem, and the alma mater. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. School board members this evening. School Board President from District 7, Mr. Art Oakley, and School Board Vice President from District 1 is Mr. Ellis Alexander, District 2, Mr. Ray Gregson, District 3, Mr. Scott Cody, District 4, Ms. Karen Boudreau, District 5, Mr. John Smith, District 6, Ms. Becky Weber, and District 8, Ms. Alex Suffren. Here to welcome you tonight is the salutatorian of this year's class, Helena Schuler. She is the daughter of Barry and Suzanne T. Schuler.
Welcome to Destrehan High School's 2023 graduation. I know my fellow classmates are eager to graduate, so I'll delay my speech no longer. May 18th, the day we've all been waiting for, the day we can throw our caps in the air and yell, "We made it!" This journey started 4 years ago. We came together at Destrehan High School as freshmen brimming with potential. We became sophomores, then juniors, forging friendships, cultivating talents, and enjoying life. We made it through the darkest corners of space and back. We've dealt with everything the universe kept throwing at us, only growing brighter with each triumph. No matter how small our wins seemed, we celebrated each and every one of them, pushing ourselves to achieve more. We're seniors now, and look how we've grown. Among each and every one of you is some special essence you can share with the world. We have all developed so much, yet have only tapped into a small portion of our true potential. Imagine how much greater it will be once we fully realize it. We are stars in the sky, shining brightly. Every challenge we conquer serves only to make the light we emit even more luminous. No matter where we end up in the world, we'll always shine together in the sky, crafting our own constellation, the Destrehan High School Class of 2023. Thank you.
Assistant Principals Mr. Frank Harding and Ms. Laura Abbey will now introduce the DHS Honor Program graduates.
It is with great pleasure that we present the valedictorian and the salutatorian and the DHS Honors Program graduates. All of these students have followed a rigorous honors curriculum and have at least an average of an 85 or better in 18 or more honors, dual enrollment, or AP classes. First, from this group of students, I would like to recognize the salutatorian of the class of 2023. Ms. Helena Schuler. And at this time, I'm honored to announce the Destrehan High School valedictorian for the class of 2023, Mr. Joshua Walton. Congratulations to both of you for your outstanding scholastic achievement. Now Ms. Abbey will introduce the DHS Honors Program graduates.
I am very proud to introduce the rest of the seniors who completed the requirements for the DHS Honors Program. We honor you for this amazing achievement. Please stand when I call your name. Lanaya Bailey. Braden Bennett. Anais Chavez, Braylon Cottingham, John Davis, Jordan Dickerson, Brandon Cortez, Allison Hebert, Hayden Cotard, Bradley Hubbard, Scott Lacey, Maria Lockwood, Emma Loper, Skylar Lopez, Reese Marcel, Evan Ransom, Caroline Rome, Abigail Schiff, Helena Schuler, Rebecca Scott, Natalie Smith, Renoa Swansea, Joshua Walther, Owen Weber, Jason White, Peyton Wider, Ethan White, Ian Winchell, Adia Young, and Eden Young. Congratulations on your fine academic record. Let's give them another nice round of applause. While time does not allow us to recognize all scholarship offers received by our seniors, we refer to you to the program for a list of those students. We are very proud to announce that this year's total for the college and community scholarships offers, including an estimate of TOPS, is $10,922,352. Congratulations to all of our scholarship recipients from the class of 2023.
Now I'd like to introduce Mr. Jason Madair, principal of Destrehan High School.
Graduates, Dr. Ortland, executive staff, school board members, distinguished guests, grandparents, parents and guardians, welcome to our 2023 graduation ceremony. Before I move on to celebrate the senior class, I want everyone to focus your attention to the right and left side of our graduates that are on the floor. This is Destrehan High School's faculty and staff that I have the privilege to work with daily. Teachers and staff, thank you for your tireless commitment to our students and our school. Thank you for your passion, your flexibility, and grace that you have, and being that teachers and students will never forget. Thank you for being who you are. Thank you for being what you are and everything that you do for Destrehan High School to make it a special place and for always putting our students first. Teachers, faculty, and staff, thank you. At a class reunion a few years back, a classmate told me that you have no idea what's going to happen, so always live in the present. But always be prepared for anything, because what comes next, you usually don't expect. That night, I didn't think much about it, but walking alongside this last 4 years with our seniors, I can't agree more. You had no clue what was coming next, but you never let it stop you. Class of 2023, although it may have taken you a while to get to your class through the plywood maze at the beginning of the year, all the way through March, we live this year's motto. Success, define it, own it, achieve it. As a class, you definitely know what success looks like and certainly have achieved it in many ways. Seniors, you're a graduating class of 322 students. You have approximately $11 million in scholarship offers, which is $2 million more than last year's class. You have earned 833 industry-based certifications, taken 569 dual enrollment courses, and 600 AP exams, which results to an interesting number right around 2,023 college credits. 15 students that scored 30 or higher on the ACT, 2 platinum scores on word keys, 3 presidential scholar finals at the state level, 2 Posse Award winners, a Questbridge Scholar, a ROTC candidate who received a Flight Academy scholarship, who will be in the air this summer, and once again, you made Destrehan an A school. In the fall, your class is prepared to move and represent your family, yourself, and selfishly Destrehan High School by attending universities like Southeastern, LSU, Tulane, Grambling, Nichols, Colorado State, La Tech, Notre Dame, Westline, Missouri, Millsaps, Ole Miss, and Columbia, just to name a few. 10 students have enlisted in the military. Thank you for your service. Twelve of you have already received technical certification from RPCC in the medical field and refrigeration trade. Some are entering trade school to focus on skills in high demand areas, while others step into the workforce with certifications accomplished already at DHS and the Satellite Center. This year, athletics programs continue to shine with state playoff appearances, with several district championships, with cross country going to state for the first time in school history. We had golfers qualify for regionals, not to be outdone by tennis qualifying for the state tournament. Swim relays were state runner-ups and the team's best top five finish in the state. By the way, we had a 5A state championship football team once again. Not to mention the best student section in the world. These teams not only were filled with special athletes, but several were recognized as academic all-state teams, and as well as the school record of 19 of these students signed college scholarships in 6 different sports. Our cheerleaders and Destiny Darlings continue to dominate the competition, were state champions again, and displayed how talented they are in Dallas and Orlando for nationals. The band and color guard continue to grow and were showcased in parades, on the field, and festival with individual earning positions, not only at the district level, but the state level. Choir brought home 2 sweepstakes trophy superior rating and had the experience of a lifetime singing at Carnegie Hall. Destrehan Theater seniors stole the show once again in Wizard of Oz and Clue. Robotics team 3039 made team history this year by winning the Magnolia Regional, being awarded the Spirit Award in 3 different events, and competing in the world competition in Houston, finishing ranked first in Louisiana and in the top 3% in the world. Among all these accomplishments, our students found ways to complete over 2,000 hours of community service through ROTC, WISE, Interact, NHS, and Beta, just to name a few. Class of 2023, you definitely owned it, and you're an amazing group, and I wish I had all night because I would sit up here and brag about you. Success, define it, own it, and achieve it. You hear me say it all the time, and now every day when you walk through the hall, you get to see it. So what does that statement mean to your future? 10 years from now, when you gather at your class reunion, will you make a statement that will impact your classmates? Where will you be? Some of you will have started a family. Some will be finishing up your MBAs and medical school. Some will be working on careers that are making impacts all across the world. Some might even be teaching at Destrehan High School, science for that fact. Whatever it is, make sure it's something that you want, guys. Always strive to reach your dreams and never let anyone tell you you can't. Even if you don't get exactly where you want to be, every night when you go to bed knowing you gave your best. Life is too short to ask what if. Never have regrets or dwell on mistakes, for it's mistakes that make us who we are. One guarantee in life is you will make mistakes and you will question yourself at times, but those moments often lead to some of the best times of your life. Don't let mistakes define you. It's what you do after mistakes that determine your success. Remember, success we hope to all achieve and can be attained if we own it daily and make it happen. Class of 2023, on behalf of the entire DHS faculty and my administrative team, I want to wish you the best of luck in everything you do as you walk out these doors tonight into your future. It has been an absolute honor and privilege to be your principal at the school where tradition never graduates. But class of 2023, you have accomplished everything that you need to do in order to graduate tonight. Congratulations and best wishes to all of you.
Delivering the commencement address tonight is Dr. Ken Ortley, Superintendent of St. Charles Parish Public Schools. Please welcome him.
Good evening. Once again, welcome parents, family, teachers, board members, employees, and most importantly, welcome again, graduating class of 2023. Come on, we gotta get excited, 23. So first, before I get started, much like Mr. Mater said, I'd first like to address some very important people in the school system. If you're a board member, a teacher, food service staff, counselor, bus operator, nurse, paraeducator, if you are an employee of St. Charles Parish Public Schools, please rise and remain standing. While nothing accomplishes ever without pitfalls, heartache, or frustration, we have not wavered in our approach and steadfast commitment to excellence in ensuring each student here tonight, the graduating class of 2023, has been provided the necessary developmental tools and opportunities that prepare them for their future. Thank you for your commitment to excellence and your commitment to ensuring each and every one of these students and all the students that are coming behind them are provided those tools. I am infinitely grateful for your commitment, for your sacrifice, for our students, for the school system, community, and state. Thank you. Now to our graduates. You have had a remarkable journey, especially the last 4 years, right? Platooning on an AV schedule due to the pandemic, to sharing a campus at Hahnville High School for half a year, once again, AV schedule, to returning to your campus in beautified fashion to a campus I'm sure you'll never forget the sight of as it was repaired from Hurricane Ida. And thankfully, completing this year with probably not too many challenges from the outside, but I'm sure you dealt with personally each and every day or throughout the school year. Congratulations to making it to this point tonight. Now, while you've heard some great advice tonight so far, and you'll probably hear some more from our valedictorian, I want to give you just a little bit of advice hopefully you'll walk away with remembering. It involves a very simple piece of silverware and a Bible. So I'm going to tell you a short story that I heard recently and I've adapted it for you graduating class of 2023. And hopefully you will pay attention. So there was an elderly woman, Miss Mercy, diagnosed with a terminal illness, who was told that she'd have 3 months to live. Her doctor had told her, start making arrangements for your passing in a few months. So the first thing she thought of, let me get in touch with my pastor, Pastor John. So she called Pastor John on the phone, Pastor, can you please come over to my house tonight? I want to talk about a few things about my services that are going to be occurring in a few months. Later, Pastor John comes knocking on that door, Miss Mercy. Oh, come on in, Pastor John. Pastor John sits on the couch next to Miss Mercy. Miss Mercy, how can I help you? How can I help you prepare for your services that may be in a few months? Well, she said, as a matter of fact, Pastor John, first and foremost, please play Wind Beneath My Wings. I absolutely love that song. Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We'll certainly play Wind Beneath My Wings. That is a great song to play at your services. And Pastor John, I want to make sure that you have two verses read at my services. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. What would that be? First, John 14, 1 through 3. 1 to 3. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And of course, John 3, 16. Whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Yes, ma'am. That's two beautiful, beautiful scriptures. They will certainly be read at your services. Pastor John, I just have one more request. Miss Murray, well, actually two more requests. Yes, ma'am. What are those two requests? Well, first, please make sure I'm in my beautiful Sunday blue dress and my white veil. I really love that outfit. Yes, ma'am. Make sure you tell your family that too now. But I will certainly make sure that that happens. Pastor John, my last request. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. How can I help you? Whatever it is. She said, I want you to make sure that you bury me or you provide me an opportunity in my casket to be buried with the Bible in my left hand. Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. And a fork in my right. Pastor John pauses. Pastor, you okay? You understand? I want the Bible in my right, in my left, and this fork in my right. Well, Miss Mercy, I'm not quite sure what you mean with the fork in your right. Oh, let me explain, Pastor John. Let me explain. You see, Pastor, in all my years of attending events, of attending dinners, functions, the favorite part of that meal was at the end of the meal when that waiter, that waitress would come there and pull in those plates and pull in the bowl and lean over and say, keep your fork. She says, Pastor, I knew when that waiter or waitress said that, it wasn't going to be Jell-O. It wasn't going to be pudding. Right? It was going to be, man, it might be chocolate cake covered in ice cream. Might be one of those big chocolate chip cookies in those hot skillets, right? Man, just something you could not wait for. But what I knew, Pastor John, was that the best was yet to come. So, Pastor John, when you're presiding over my services and I'm laying in my casket, please keep the Bible in my left and the fork in my right. Because, Pastor John, when I see them walk past me, I want them to ask you, why does she have a fork in her right hand? Pastor, then I want you to tell them, something better is coming, so you keep your fork as well. In other words, for Miss Mercy, she realized that the best was yet to come in heaven and not necessarily leaving behind what was here on earth. That's pretty powerful, graduates. And I hope you leave here tonight with this simple phrase, keep your fork. When you come across a challenging moment in college or career or your life, keep your fork. When you break up with your girlfriend or boyfriend, hopefully not anytime soon or anytime in the future, but if you do, keep your fork. If you're injured on a field or playing something maybe after school, keep your fork. When you get turned down by a job opportunity, keep your fork. You see, keeping your fork means having a positive attitude and mindset that the best in life is yet to come. It's ahead of you and not behind you. This mindset will clear the possibilities for you and not close the door to missed opportunities. Have you ever heard of somebody said, man, that person is so positive, they get on my nerves? Probably, but let's just play along. Having a positive attitude and a positive mindset, statistically, have been proven a better healthy and more productive both mentally and physically life, as well as job satisfaction. So while your diploma that you're going to receive tonight is really a mile marker of what you've accomplished in the past, it's just that. It's the past. Keeping this mindset, keeping this fork, Keeping the mindset that the best is yet to come will open the door to endless possibilities. So graduating class of 2023, I wish each and every one of you well. You have done tremendous things on your pathway to this night tonight, but remember, keep your fork. Congratulations, class of 2023. Go Fighting Wildcats!
It is tradition that the graduate's farewell is given by the valedictorian, who is a DHS Honors Program student with the highest overall average. Please welcome our valedictorian for the class of 2023, Joshua Waltler, son of Christopher and Lisa Waltler.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone, class of 2023, parents, teachers, family, friends. It is an honor to stand before you here tonight as we celebrate all of our hard work and dedication up to this point. After what feels like an all too short 4 years at Destrehan High School, tonight, this chapter in our lives reaches a close. I'm relieved it's finally over, but it's undoubtedly a time I'll remember fondly. Tonight is more than just a graduation. Tonight, we, the Destrehan class of 2023, stand together at a crossroads in our lives, an intersection of our past and all of life ahead of us. As my best friend always reminds me, life is not a single mountain with its ups and downs, but a mountain range. It's a series of mountains we are all forced to climb, and we have worked tirelessly to surmount this peak. And tonight, at its apex, we discover we are not at the finish line. Instead, we find a whole new range of mountains towering in front of us. Who is it that we wish to be? Where is it that our lives will take us? How will we make our dreams come true? It's all daunting to think about, our whole lives ahead of us. In this moment, we look ahead, and the thought of it all can feel so paralyzing, a thick, almost suffocating fog obscuring our view. The pressure of the future can feel exhaustingly overwhelming, but also incredibly exciting and full of potential. Behind the clouds of doubt that blind us, a great light shines through. All of the possibilities, the success, the triumphs, all the great fruits that life can bring. All our dreams and hopes waiting to be fulfilled. As we prepare to descend from this mountain tonight and begin to climb our next, I think it's fair we take a moment at this mountain's peak to reflect on the path we've traveled. Let's take a moment to look back at the trials we've overcome, and most importantly of all, let's take a moment to look around and recognize all those standing by our sides, those who have helped us up after we slipped, those that have helped make this dream possible. I think it's an understatement to say our school experience has been rocky. From COVID forcing us online and separating us, to Hurricane Ida ripping through our community and destroying our school. But for there to be a peak, there first has to be valleys. And these harrowing times, we persevered and survived, and now we're stronger for it. From the rubble of Destrehan was rebuilt a shiny new commons and gym, and it's never looked better. Then, looking to us as a student body, our football team won the state championship, the robotics team won state and went to Worlds, our track, tennis, and baseball teams achieved success at the state competitions, along with a plethora of other athletic successes, and millions of dollars in scholarship money awarded to us from colleges all around the country. Although we stumbled, we climbed back higher than we could ever reach before. And tonight, we stand at the top. Our success is not just defined by the greatness of our achievements, but also by all of the obstacles we've overcome to achieve it. We've made up for all the time we've lost and made every moment of this, our only normal high school year, count. At the start of senior year, I reflected on all the time I lost, and I realized that I'd been wasting so much of it, playing my life with the same tasks. After losing so much time, I decided to spend it more wisely. I started to go out with my friends. I formed deeper connections with people I never imagined I would interact with. My recent volunteering and working with kids inspired me to channel the hidden childhood curiosity deep within me. I reinvented who I wanted to be by becoming part of the world around me, instead of simply watching from the sidelines. We only have so much time, so I'm doing my best, and I encourage you all to look at your lives closely. However, We've learned that these challenging times cannot be surmounted alone. With every stumble that we take, there are always those by our side who will pick us up and put us back on our feet. Think of all those who have helped guide you to this peak, those who helped you when you began to slide, those who lent a hand when you stumbled, the teachers who guided you, the parents who love and care for you, the friends who will always be by your side. Without them, we cannot persevere through life's challenges. Your whole life is thanks to those who sacrificed and cared for you. So I'm asking you to make their sacrifices worth it. Push yourself to do your best, if not just for yourself, but for those who love you. In our darkest times and our lowest moments, remember, there will always be someone else fighting alongside you. So keep them close and recognize their support. With that said, I'd like to give some thanks of my own. I thank my mom for working hard to support me and keep me on track. My dad for always showing up to cheer me on for every tennis match. My grandma, Honey, for raising me every snowball she bought me. My brother and my family flying here to see me tonight. My aunts, my uncles, cousins, for their words of encouragement. And most importantly, the big man in my house. And my favorite brother, my little lion, Gizmo, whose 10 pounds I love so much, even with all his barking. I'd like to thank all my coaches and all my teachers. Miss Nizak, always challenging to think deeper. Mrs. Jacoby, always pushing me to be hungry. Mrs. Green's passion and commitment to all of her students. And Miss Bordelon for fostering my growth and teaching me the product of 7 and 4. It's 28. And most importantly, my friends who are always right by my side and care for me. Your contributions to my life will always be appreciated. I truly cannot thank you enough. And now, a look towards the future, to the mountains that stand before us. It's hard to tell where we'll end up in 10 to 15 years. I don't know what my future holds, what other mountains I'll be asked to face. There's so much life to live and an all too short time to live in, so there's no time to waste. COVID and Ida taught me that. Our whole lives are built on the foundation of those who came before us, the schools we walk through, the roads we drive on, and the values we uphold, all thanks to their work. To think what we take for granted all started with a spark of a flame some hundreds of thousands of years ago. So I dream big. If every human leaves a mark, a stone along the path of life, adding to the foundation of human achievement, then make yours seen, make yours you. You don't have to change the world. You don't have to save lives. Just leave a stone for others to follow. We will each traverse our own mountains. They'll have their peaks and valleys, but you don't have to face them alone. If you haven't already, find your family, find your friends, those that are true to you, and keep them close. So as you prepare to cross this stage, remember, life's not a race to reach the end of the mountain range. It's about climbing through it and eventually reaching out to touch the clouds. Congratulations, class of 2023, and thank you.
We have arrived at the special part of the program that we, the seniors of class of 2023, have been waiting for, the conferring of the diplomas. Dr. Ken Orling, Mr. Jason Madere, and Mr. Art Oakland will do the honors, assisted by Ms. Tracy Blanchard and Ms. Jessica Glass. Mr. Madere will now formally present the graduates.
Walking across the stage to receive a diploma is an extremely important event in the lives of our graduates. We know you want to cheer for your favorite graduate, but we ask you to show your support by holding your applause until all the graduates have been presented. It's important that everyone can hear the names of their graduates, as well as the academic honors. Dr. Orland, the member of the 2023 graduating class of Destrehan High School, have completed all requirements for graduation as determined by the Louisiana Board of Elementary and Secondary Education. They have been approved and recommended by the faculty. They await their diplomas.
Shula, summa cum laude. Lanaya Bailey, magna cum laude. Right,
Braden Benedict, magna cum laude. Hope Bird, summa cum laude. Andrew Bowler, magna cum laude. Gabrielle Brown, cum laude. John Chauvin, magna cum laude. Anais Chavez, magna cum laude. Braylon Cunningham, magna cum laude. Cassidy Crawford, summa cum laude. Skylar Dozet, magna cum laude. Brijan Davis, magna cum laude. Jordan Dickerson, summa cum laude. Brandon Fortes, magna cum laude. Allison Adair, magna cum laude. Hayden Hotard, magna cum laude. Bradley Hubbard Jr., cum laude. Scott Lacey, magna cum laude. Maria Lockwood, summa cum laude. Emma Looper, magna cum laude. Skylar Lopez, magna cum laude. Reese Marcel, magna cum laude. Evan Ransom, magna cum laude. Caroline Rome, magna cum laude. Abigail Schiff, magna cum laude. Rebecca Scott, summa cum laude. Natalie Smith, summa cum laude. Renoa Swansea, magna cum laude. Owen Weber, magna cum laude. Jason White, magna cum laude. Peyton Whiter, cum laude. Ethan White, magna cum laude. Ian Winchell, magna cum laude. Adia Young, cum laude. Eden Young, cum laude. Brody Carver. Aaron Adams. Kevin Adams III. Joyce Alegría Bernhardt. Brianne Anderson. Brianna. Magnum cum laude. Marcon Anderson. Kennedy Bankston, cum laude. Renee Barbazon. Kyron Barnes. Brittany Barrios, cum laude. Jean Barrios, cum laude. Leona Berto. Daniel Mudd, cum laude. DeAndre Blue. Star Blue. Luke Bordelon, cum laude. Brett Bordelon. Christian Bowler, magna cum laude. Christian Bourgeois. bourgeois. Marissa Britt. Jaden Brown. Chriselle Brown. Samantha Booker Cum Laude. Victoria Byrd, magna cum laude. Johansi Cabrera. Jimena Calera Abada. Kirsten Cannon. LaCorey Cannon. Landry Cannon. John Carmichael, magna cum laude. Simone Catalano. Nicole Cavagna-Lanez, cum laude. Michael Felius. Ezekiel Chavez. Sarah Rose Plessy. Chaz Cole. Maya Collins Phillips. Tiandra Cooks. Alexia Cortez. Jaleel Clawkins.
Destrehan Cross, cum laude. Esteban Cruz. Grace Downey, cum laude. Emily Davis. Madison DeFrisco. Alyssa DeLon. Lainey Delcom, cum laude. James DeVille II, magna cum laude. Adrian Doherty. Jordan Donadue, cum laude. Taylor Donaldson, magna cum laude. Jeremy Dragon, cum laude. Raquan Ducree, cum laude. Matthew Duffy, magna cum laude. Rebecca Dugas, cum laude. Paris Duay, cum laude. Sarah Salmada. Logan Estela. Jai Eugene Jr. Tayari Eugene Suma Colby Fabry. Mohammed Bayazian. Ella Boshe. Riley Fayard, cum laude. Emily Ferguson, cum laude. Luke Ferguson. Elizabeth Ford. Gabrielle Ford. Brandon Freeman Jr. Fernando Gallo Castellano Jr.
Isaiah Garnett Cum Laude. Jessica Garibay Cum Laude. Tristan Godet. Delana Gautreau. Skylar Gayton, cum laude. Jalea Gibson, magna cum laude. Adriana Gilmore, magna cum laude. Marilyn Gore, cum laude. Sophia Goenaga Espinosa. Eden Goodwin. Kelsey Gordon. Jacoby Green. Lydia Guichard, magna cum laude. James Guidry III. Maylin Guidry, magna cum laude. Adam Nguyen. Aiden Hales. Aaliyah Ahmed. Alexander Hamilton. Bryson Harding, cum laude. Jamie Hartis. Amber Hawk, magna cum laude. Lenard Harris. Thank you.
Savannah Hess, cum laude. Leah Hollis, cum laude. Melvin Howard. Valencia Hunter.
Switch your room?
Yes, ma'am. Best idea ever, by the way.
Caden Jackson. Jalea Jackson. Radejanique Jackson. Rahan Jackson. Leslie Jefferson III. Devon Jenkins. Dylan Johnson. Jaden Johnson. Ronnie Johnson III. Roland Ledrette III. Jake Lear. Anna Marie Lede cum laude. Joshua Lejeune cum laude. Thank you. Olivia Neenhammer, cum laude.
Hannah Robbery.
George Ruiz, cum laude. Braden Russell. Gianna Ryan, cum laude. Aja Sanchez, cum laude. Lauren Sawyer. Nicholas Sawyer, cum laude. Andrew Schaefer, cum laude. Victoria Schick. Troy Schwenkhardt, Jr. Jalea Scott, cum laude. Joshua Scott. Montasia Scott. Jamel Seymour. Michael Shaver. Mia Shotwell, cum laude. Jayon Sim. Joshua Stokes, magna cum laude. Devin Stout. Lane Stute. Tyrone Strawer. Hannah Tallarico.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, the 2023 DHS commencement will conclude with the recession to the DHS fight song. As the graduates begin to file out tonight, we ask you to remain in place until they have all exited. After the graduates leave, please exit the same doors through which you've entered. The graduates will meet you at your vehicle or at alternate location. There can be no gathering in front of the Pontchartrain Center. Ladies and gentlemen, I am very proud to present to you the graduating class of 2023.